In this particular game, I think one of the big saving graces, as Chronicler pointed out heading into the game, was we're going to see a bit of a trade here. Is Faker is on the rise, and he is going to be able to
discuss that at the beginning of the day. We can get back to that as Kana really trying to force this fight, making it very obvious that Owner could be on the top side of the map. And maybe the bait actually works.
This is what I'm talking about. You overextend, you get punished.
And here we go. The flash will come out already. As Owner just being a menace up here in the top side, so annoying.
You're in the LCK, where you have this ability to punish someone who's trying to harass this Gragas, especially post-6, because he's such an easy punish champion.
Here's Faker, by the way, up in the top side, sneaking around in the enemy jungle, doing an incredible amount of damage. And we just get a solo kill onto the Jace. First blood goes over to Kana.
Teleport from Faker there. Even pre-6 ties into the power that he has, enabling the rest of his team. And because Khan like is forced to shove in his way, he's kind of in a very disadvantage. Has no mana, has no health. Love the confidence from Khan to go for that. And really nice punish by T1. Faker enabling his top side this early on, even without a Realm Warp.
He should know that the Gragas is here, and now Faker kind of corralling them up against this wall. Canyon is going to have to flash, it looks like, as a lot of damage comes out, and Canyon's still around here. The stun coming in. He wants to wait until the last possible moment, but again, they get another flash.
Extra plate comes through, they get the Rift Herald gold, and T1 with a nice lead in this early game.
Cute deny there as well by Kana. Khan.
Here we go again. Khan's going to get flash stunned, and he will flash away from this one, but is there enough damage as he's trying to just kite this one out? He knocks him into the arrow! Are you kidding me? And that's enough to keep him safe. Faker will be able to secure that kill eventually, you'd have to imagine, and there it does go, but Showmaker, he is desperately trying to get that CD back right now, but look at that Braum ult is going to catch the both of them. This is looking dire. T1, it will pay off, although they're only going to be able to get the one, and now here comes Showmaker. The Shock Blast misses, as that one was nearly lined up for him,
the cast
comes in, and that's going to be Kata just putting him in the trash. Down he does go, and the arrow will just sail wide. It doesn't amount to anything, and Barrel's left all alone here. He will have to flash, and Kana is still chasing after them.
What a performance from Kana tonight. In both of these games, he's had phenomenal performances, first on the Kana, now on the Gragas. And, you know, T1 fans have been really critical of performance all year long, and even going back as far as last year. And he is coming up big in their most important match here.
Oh, of events, right? So much gold going over into the pockets of T1 as... Yeah.
This is going to be the knock into the arrow. It's perfect because it also denies him the chase there. And he's stunned under turret.
And after such a...
Look at the legends that are with him up there.
Carius becoming an engaged support, it looks like, on this one as a huge encore comes in, but there's zero follow-up.
Right here, the collapse comes through.
Gone. Okay, the Q is going to miss. There's a lot of damage from the Jace, but it's not quite enough. Faker with the phase rush looking for the follow-up, and he flashes in and picks up another huge kill for his team.
NT1 keeps finding more and more of these objectives.
Oh, and this isn't even a fight you can take as Dom won. The distortion does nothing, and Faker gets a flank, but he's kind of all alone here. Can they take him out before anybody else gets over here is the question. The exhaust is going to be big. Takes him down, the shutdown will go to Ghost.
If you do go in to T1's comp, you have to be ready. Oh, this is looking bad.
All right, this is a big encore, though, but Stopwatch comes in once again. The damage not quite there. Carrier going to get away, but here Khan. And then now Showmaker trying to come up as finally they do take out the Braum, and T1 is kind of zoned into the enemy jungle here once again. Faker, though, full health.
I mean, if you get hit by a Q from Varus and that Gragas barrel, you're dead. The better they go for T1. For Damwon Kia, you really need to have that explosive engage. You need to use your combos, or you got to get a lot of poke damage done before the fight starts.
And you know what? They have it in spades. There's a decent amount on the side of T1, though. You can see
all this tankiness that's available. Is Faker on a ward?
He's on a ward here, and he has no idea. Canyon, Ghost, and Showmaker all up on the top side. Flash comes in. You're not able to flash the pillar. Nice try, Faker, but not going to happen this time. And guess who they give the kill over to?
Unfortunately, there's no getting out of this scenario once you're caught. He tries to get the Realm Warp, even flashing there. It's not going to be enough. You're just kind of locked in place here.
It was
the pillar
nice
is so
try.
Good. But he even uses his Zhonya's here to buy time, which is another tool he's not going to have for a few more seconds. But like you mentioned, there's just dryers.
It's kind of rough. I kind of like how Damwon are playing it. They know that T1 would like to get some good poke damage in and just force them away, but they're playing very far back, trying to avoid that damage. Arrow is going to come out. It hits the Braum, though. Not necessarily the target you're looking for. Showmaker going to flash in. The Encore is nothing. And T1 going to drink, and here's the engage. Down goes Beryl. And now, the squishiness will come in for the side of Damwon Kia. They don't have that Seraphine, and Showmaker not going to be locked down, though. He will remain on full health. Area pretty low as well. Got to be careful about doing that, but they will be. But still, this is a big Viego, and now they're trying to make a move here onto Khan, who is just going to flash away. Arrow and Encore going to sail wide into thin air as Showmaker looking for a little bit more. There's a lot of team fight tools taken away from Damwon and T1. They have all their Fed members right in the front there, kind of waiting, threatening from the pit. And so is Baker. They're just going to root down Showmaker. The cask is going to do a ton of damage. Kana, though, take a lot himself and even gets knocked up from the Baron.
The opposition is so reliant on having that extra information. They don't have it. They can't make the plays. And T1 rush down the Drake. They're on Soul Point now.
Oh, Kana. You can see it, the Realm Warp is coming in. Four members are coming out behind Damwon. Was that the right play? I'm not sure. Count is going to go down, and it's not looking good for T1 now. They're trying to kite it out, though. Canyon nearly dies, but the subjugate is there, and T1, they're once again corralled into a really awkward spot against a Pokecom. This is not where you want to be against Ashe and Trundle and Chase. They're all just going down one by one, and Damwon are just chasing him through the jungle. Not sure how many more they'll be able to get, but definitely some more chase potential from the side of Damwon. Looks like the speed of the Viego will be enough to get him away. But
Baron control.
They're just going to go for the Baron because there's nothing that T1 can do.
And this is a pivotal turn. T1, though, they don't want to give it up. They're still there.
Baker, he tried to flash away from that one, and now he's just going to die. Down he goes just like that, and Gumiyusi.
This play doesn't end up paying off for them, but they do stop the Baron. Gumiyusi.
Oh man, just look at that poke. The cask is thrown at Canyon. He's like, yeah, whatever, dude. Just gonna run away from that one. The damage going out now on the Baker as the Encore looks like it landed. Showmaker super low, but it's just LeBlanc with the teleport available here to get back into the fight. His owner trying to get something going onto Showmaker, not quite able to do that. The chains are just gonna chunk him so low. Take a look at that damage now onto owner. He cannot get close, and it will be Baron for the side of Damwon.
You gotta get out of here, it's T1.
But they didn't have a lot of vision around the Baron. They were not able to quite get the engage they were looking for. And now, after that fight, Damwon took away all those control wards. And now what are you gonna do? The Encore's gonna come in. This time, Canyon in a bit of trouble. Showmaker trying to help him out, the flash coming in, and now owner's getting into that back line. Will he have the reset? Look at this Viego go wild now. That Showmaker gonna take down his GA.
He's got a res, yeah.
And the poke is here, it's still here for the side of Damwon. The volleys rather are coming out from the S. And Faker says, okay guys, let's just go and burst down the dragon.
They've got control wards, they can control this vision and this choke point.
The poke comes in, but again, at the same time, it's like you're on the opposite side of this poke. They're just trying to get the smite down on time and with it coming in, but Showmaker has the damage and he takes out two, but the Infernal Soul will go the way of T1. Can Owner and Kana salvage it? No! Damwon wins the fight and they're teleporting to try to end the game.
36 minutes in, they win a fight. Two risky plays off Realm Warps back to back from T1 backfire. What a tragic way to go out. They had such a lead in this game. It started to fade. They lost vision control. Then they made two Realm Warp plays that did not pay off.
And it looks like the overextension from Damwon, right? Like they're diving underneath the turret into a Braum, into a composition with this much power, but I think they might have done it.
Looks like this is going to be it, guys. Game number four is going to go the way of Damwon. They just have to hit the Nexus. And Damwon Kia will be your champions of LCK Summer. here for the finals. We were pretty split between two players. Showmaker will pick up the MVP for the Summer LCK 2021.
Insanely good decision making, and even being a showman himself, living up to his name, playing the cast in two games in a row in a grand finals, one that had so much importance. Let's not talk about the second time, but the first time, I thought it was beautiful. And like I said, that LeBlanc.
Let's give them their moment.
That LeBlanc. Let's watch as they hoist the trophy here in the middle of this beautiful stage.